He's making love to his tonic and gin.
Early gas mask. While gas masks were in more widespread use on the front, they were also available to civilians and in French towns close to the front, like Reims.
Found it, by the way.
They were fairly common. This early model was one of the first composed of a cotton compress doused in a neutralizing solution and applied to the mouth and nose, similar to a British black veil. That villain, that is a lot of information. I'm missing a square.
Well, that was the other thing I was thinking about, is that females go through heat, which can really affect things. But apparently, I found the answer to my question, which spaying and neutering cats and dogs were not widely available or accessible until the 1930s. So, at this time, it would likely not have been.
Interesting.
These are the things that go through my mind.
I mean, you learn something new every day, so...
That has
don't worry
to be
about
collectible
it.
Over there. Yes, dog. Please go near that fire just to get me a collectible.
Sacrifice the dog's life.
Advertising brochure. While the war raged on, life continued back home, and brands still advertised their products. Naturally, soldiers were used to promote brand image and boost sales. This brochure is advertising war bonds to help the government finance the war effort. War Godmother Certificate. To improve morale on the front, an association was created in France in early 1915 to provide succor and support from behind the lines for soldiers without close families. The War Godmother sent letters and parcels forming close relations with their godchildren away from the front.
Interesting.
The last thing I'm missing? I am missing, like, this piece of square thing. Let me check that up here.
It's sort of weird how you're starting this game right now, because last night, Villain and I watched Atlantis, the Disney movie, and that also takes place during World War I. And there's, like, nothing that's, like, there's, like, no media at all on World War One.
Well, Battlefield One, but that's not a World War One game.
That doesn't
no.
count.
That's a Battlefield game where you're a inhumane robot. How do I get this child from back there?
Oh, merci.
Venonat.
Wait, what about a Venonat?
All the Venonat.
Tell me about it.
Yeah, World War One and yeah, exactly, Ben. World War One in America didn't really.
They joined in 1917 and ended in 1918.
Yeah.
Yep. About it.
Besides, as far unless like
they're like, I guess we'll help.
Yeah. It was basically they were sitting there like, who's gonna win here? Oh, it looks like this side's about to win. We'll join them.
Kind of. Yes,
you are. I mean, wasn't World War One where the British basically tricked us into thinking that the Germans attacked us and that's why we joined up with them?
You're thinking of the sinking of the Lusitania. That wasn't really anyone tricked us. It was...
No, I heard it was the British... Like, they found out the British actually did, like, sink that ship.
No.
Okay.
No, Lusitania was actually sunk by a German U-boat.
Making love to his tonic engine.
Bullshit.
Said son, can you play me a memory?
The US got into both world wars by ships sinking.
That's true.
I don't know how. Wait, you're good.
You're one good. Of them was just a lot more extreme than the other.
Yeah.
That's generally why World War II is so well portrayed.
Yeah.
It was just more interesting.
Fuck the Nazis.
And I mean, like, the battle system itself was more interesting because World War One was trench warfare.
Battle system? You make it sound like an RPG.
World War One RPG. Trench warfare was only a small piece of the equation. Like, you had the modern tank effectively first came onto the battlefield.
Oh, cool.
You still had, like, horse cavalry, shit like that.
Yeah.
Like, you had the transition between, like, the gentleman's war of the Revolution and the Civil War to modern warfare, in a sense.
Active service paybook. A paybook belonging to a British soldier. I don't know why I have problems with that word. It also contained practical details such as a last will and testament form, as well as the names and addresses of close relatives and contacts in the event of death. The book also served as a regulations and guide to good conduct, advising men, quote, "In this new experience, you may find temptations both in wine and women. You must entirely resist both." And I have all the collectibles.
Hey, what? Bye-bye.
What do you pop out of?
Wieners and wine.
Wieners and wine.
Oh, I like wieners and wine.
Aren't they fine?
If you like a wieners and wine, you can have some of mine.
God, I love him.
Question mark, Rodney, question mark.
Rodney Carrington, that's his name.
Yep.
Live at the Majestic.
Teddy's a bear.
Oh man, I think I have a puzzle.
That's plausible.
Oh, you're in a church.
Take me to church. Oh, or is this a boss fight? What the fuck?
Man, wieners are fun.
Shove it in your buns.
I'll just watch the juice run and just. Okay. No more.
That man is a deacon in his church. They don't know he does that.
This was not a boss fight.
I mean, it's...
Dude, I'm the American again, whose bag, like, buttons look like nipples.
Time to see this. I mean, you're right. So, what year does this game take place then? 1917, I assume?
Yeah. Oh. Thank you, Villain. You're just hosting it because I took your sexy boyfriend. That makes sense. not sexy boyfriend.
I mean, don't you have multiple villains? Isn't that how that works?
No, she has a boyfriend and a girlfriend. The girlfriend's Kate. Combat in those games, that's why the boss fight has to be like weird like this.
So like what's like the gameplay style? Is just kind of like
puzzles.
Puzzle exploration.
Yeah. Throw a grenade into a, you know, into a zeppelin.
So do you never shoot a weapon?
I have like once. And it was a cannon.
Oh.
I just got the title screen? What the fuck? I'm playing this game for 2 hours.
Nice.
Well, villain, he's gonna give him back after the stream's over.
Anna was training to be a veterinarian
when
the war broke out.
You have no idea what he's planning to do.
The Germans were only 20 miles from Paris when she received a letter from her father.
I'm there in 4 days, so...
But implored her not to return home to Belgium until the war's end.
I should say down. You're technically north of her.
Patience, however, was not one of the strong suits.
You didn't answer the question, you just said yes.
Yeah.
But I know for a fact he's driving.
Sorry, I must have not been paying attention or something. I worked today. I'm a little tired. Nah, I don't work tomorrow, so I can sleep in. Wait, are you Wallman now?
Villain,
you can try, but you can actually join into this.
No, you can't.
John has to drag you in.
I will drag you in. Yeah, I moved the whole thing.
I've done that more times than you'd think.
Hi, sweetie.
Hi.
Hey,
I had a spot.
Okay.
Night after Troy fell asleep, and I've had this thought several nights, and I keep forgetting to say something. Since Rachel's allowed to visit, like, does she want a drive back up to St. Catherine's?
I mean,
Troy and I can drop her off in St. Catherine's.
If that's okay with you, sweetie.
I mean,
it takes an hour onto our car trip, though.
I mean, I think she has to leave Monday because she has school Tuesday.
Mm.
So, but I mean, I could ask. And just be like, hey.
What about a ride down? Like, just could try to pick her up. If that's okay with you, sweetie.
I mean, I'll ask her,
well,
Troy.
Well, we talked about doing it for MAGFest.
Yeah. Troy, I can message her and ask her.
Okay.
Woo MAGFest.
Because, like, she's what, like an hour from...
She's Sudbury.
She's like an hour or something from the Sioux. And it puts like a tiny, I think a 1 hour addition onto Troy's trip.
Well, like I said, it's your
that also means you'd be there like 5 days early.
Oh yeah, right. Shit, duh.
Never mind on that then.
Never mind. Sorry. Never mind.
I was like, wait a second.
But if she wants a lift back, because now we're gonna leave on the same day that you leave, instead of staying an extra day, because I'm going back with him. For Turkey Day.
You gonna do that American Thanksgiving?
Yeah, I didn't get my Canadian one.
Sorry.
I spent it in an airport and then in a car.
Ew. Yeah. Yikes.
That's her own fault, though. Because she wasn't thinking about holidays when she booked a trip.
I mean,
I think you were actually the one. You were the one that booked that one, too. I don't think I did.
I didn't read these. Inkwell. Ballpoint pens were not developed until the 1950s and 60s, so soldiers used a quill or nib to write letters. Ink was poured into an inkwell into which, in order to write enough ink, the quill or nib had to be dipped regularly.
Mm-hmm.
Letter from a Belgian civilian in Paris. Dear parents, we fled our land before the German advance to take shelter in France with the children. Unfortunately, the Germans kept coming forward and Paris is practically under siege. If Paris falls, we shall return home to Liege. Your dear daughter, Mathilde. I want to at least get the second achievement, which is, I think, 50, maybe? No. What's the second achievement? 30. $200 gamer score if you get every historical item, and there's over 100. Yes, now I am woman, and I have a walking stick.
So what were you before? He-Man?
The American's pretty burly.
Hey, she's cool looking.
I just realized nobody has eyes in this game.
No, they do not.
Okay, I'm gonna go back to listening to the game now.
Bye, sweetie.
I really like it.
Bye.
That is pretty cool music.
I really like it.
Ooh, the Eiffel Tower. Shoot, when was that built? Hang on. Googling.
1819.
I don't know how to spell Eiffel.
1906?
Isn't it like E-I-F-E-L-L?
E-I-F-F-E-L.
No, I know how to spell it.
I-T. That's how you spell it.
1887.
Yep. Construction started January 28th, 1887. It was completed March 15th, 1889.
I've been on that building.
I have never been off of this continent. The only foreign country I've been to is Canada.
I've been to Canada, Mexico, and Jamaica.
See ya, Ace Knight.
I haven't been out of this country either.
Smoke weed every day.
Smoke weed every day.
Newspapers. The main source of information was the newspaper. Radios were, in their early days, based on tube technology, and television did not exist. On top of local and national news, a news section appeared in the newspaper dedicated to the events of the front. Some newspapers also published daily listings of POWs and war dead. Call it POW. POW, right? Oh, the why there's so many wrenches on the floor.
Oh,
At least it's not too many wrenches, because then it'd put a wrench in your plans.
Man, I hate you.
I know you do.
I feel like you get that a lot.
I mean, you've said that to me how many times this past week?
Do you really want to suck it to him?
Oh my god. Thank you. I like you.
Yay!
Quit playing games with my...
She hits her in your heart.
Oh, I just got that. Oh my god.
Sweet child.
Sweet child.
Your hole.
Sweet child.
Is it... What the fuck? Wait, what? Is it a rhythm game?
Oh my gosh! Please tell me you get to do that, like, on someone in the battlefield. Because that would actually be cool. A rhythm game of being a nurse on the battlefield. Although I don't think the nurses actually went on the battlefield, so that doesn't make sense, but...
I don't see a I think this character does have a name, but I think they said it before you got here. I think her name is Anna. I think. I don't 100% remember. I'm also trying to find a screwdriver. Or a wrench or whatever.
So I'm assuming she is French then?
I have a thing of cold.
It's because you've been a bad boy.
How do I get that? Do I have to hit them with a thing of coal? Can I even reach? I'm trying to find that triangle socket wrench. Broken watch strap. A watch strap broken by a motor crank handle. Before battery ignition was developed, motor cars were started by cranking a handle. As the engine sparked into life, the operator had to let go of the handle smartly, because the crank handle, now propelled by the engine, could cause a nasty accident. Like, I know I need to put the bottle on. I know I need water in this, but I don't see where the wrench is. Because that's not it. I'm totally missing something. Like, these cars keep running by. There has to be something with it.
Think cars run.
That well, or this game was really out of ideas and just kept looping the same thing over and over again.
Actually, well, it's different mind. Cars. I think it's two different cars. One has a French flag on it, the other doesn't. Yep, two different cars.
They are, yeah.
Hmm.
made her healthy. So that means I got the vial. I don't see anything on this ledge. Nothing. I can't believe I can't find this fucking soccer match. This is the one thing that's stopping me from progressing. This your house? I don't know if this is my house.
It's our house. And it's in the middle of our street.
I noticed that the sign there says hotel, and I had to look up to see if hotel was the same in French as it is in English. And it is, it just has like an accent on it or something.
Yeah, hotel. There's no H in French.
Yeah, I would assume that.
There's no I in team.
This one? Yeah, it zooms in real close on it. There is?
Oh. It's just silent.
I guess, in my mind, like, I was going through it on basic knowledge of French, that, like, I would assume you would know that the H is there, but, like, you just don't say it. It's always silent. It is.
Yeah, I think that's what you meant, was it's like Spanish, where they have an H, it's just always silent.
Yes.
Because obviously it would be there if they spelled hotel with an H.
That'd be a really funny, like, continuity error, though. They just spelled shit in English. Everything else is in French, like, very clearly in French.
That's why I looked it up.
IG. La button. Top floor?
Karine et Paolo.
Hang on, I'm looking that up too.
Maybe I need something to throw at someone? That's a triangle, user.
I think he was saying use that wrench on the, thing that you couldn't before.
Oh, am I just an idiot? Got it.
You said it.
I think you gain like a frame if you time your swing right.
There is a triangle in that, yes. Also, hey G.
Okay, if I get through one of these sections without taking damage, I get an achievement. Dude, this music right now is fantastic.
Turning on stream sound to hear. Oh my gosh. Really? Fuck the music?
Fun fact, all the shit coming at you to attack you is in rhythm.
Oh my gosh.
That's awesome.
Oh my god. That music is fantastic.
That was awesome, and I can't... I saw someone read something in chat, and I can't look.
That's good one.
Spectacular, spectacular.
Can.
Singing the Friends theme, or am I crazy?
Hold on.
Like, you see, super focusing
right now.
Because that's what song's
yes.
playing right now.
Achievement.
Nice.
September 7th, 1950.
That was fucking hilarious.
Taxis drove all night. Anna was proud to help the soldiers reach the
I was not
line.
Doing the Friends theme. I can guarantee you that
when
much.
When Anna arrived okay. at her destination... She discovered the horrible
God, I'm deaf as shit.
I had to do such, like, subtle movements in between those two cars. The Hecatomb? The first 3 months of the war saw especially heavy losses. August 22nd, 1914 was the bloodiest day of the whole war. With heavy casualties, the numbers of wounded were far greater than had been anticipated. The military health services struggled to cope with the scale of the conflict. This is our third playable character of the game so far. We had the swole American, the French guy. Please give me the mini game again.
The healing mini game.
I think I had a horse trapped on top of him.
No! I see. Hey! Oh!
Well, my wish came true, I guess.
It's not as dramatic as you thought it would be, but...
Yeah. I was hoping there'd be, like, bombshells going off and limbs flying past you.
Bombshells to the beat.
7 months went by. Driven by compassion, Anna devoted herself, body and soul, to healing the wounded and the sick. Every life saved was another small victory over the war. The conflict, however, raged on.
Wow, I missed two collectibles in that first sequence. Shrapnel shell remnants. Shrapnel shell remnants, a shell containing lead bullets. Depending on its settings, the shell might explode on contact with the ground, sending its contents flying or in the air for even more destructive results. We are now in... We're still in Belgium. It is April 22nd, 1915.
Okay. The Americans shouldn't be there at this time, but I'll give it a pass.
They said... About 150 American citizens signed up for the French army.
Oh, I got... Okay. So that's why he's there. Yeah, I suppose there were probably American people in France at the time, so...
Oh, hey. Nurses Manuel. The war effort suddenly required a larger medical corps, and there were not enough qualified personnel, so manuals were published and distributed to help volunteers train. The manuals provided a whole host of practical solutions to logistical and medical problems on the front, such as how to make a splint or a stretcher using rifles and their straps.
Manuel. Well, it is French.
No,
wait,
it's 100% manual. I'm doing it because in the Binding of Isaac, I think the original Flash one, he typoed the word manual to Manuel.
Wait, really? I don't remember that.
Yes, there's a lot of typos in the Flash version of Isaac.
Yeah.
Is that supposed to be a shower? If so, why is the pole handle outside of the tent?
Mess tins with holes. Both dishes of this mess tin have holes in them. Not hugely practical for eating, perhaps, but life-saving for one soldier. The mess tin bag was worn at kidney height. When the shell exploded, this mess tin slowed down the searing hot shrapnel in flight, which, although it wounded the soldier, helped him live another day. Mess tins were blackened using smoke to prevent them glinting in the sunlight. Glinting in the sunlight, having a wonderful time.
I'm so happy. I'm so happy. Oh.
Hey, what down? Yes, I know people are dying. I need to get my collectible though. Give me a minute.
Oh boy, you got a saw.
I got a scarf that wasn't a collectible, actually. Do I need to, use this as a tourniquet or something?
Wait, you used a saw to knot? And you used the saw on not a person? I expected you to amputate something.
Probably will. Socks! Tallow socks. Socks soaked in refined tallow and coated with formal, the most effective way to beat the cold and damp, frostbite, and other ailments. That, at least, was what the adverts had people believe. However effective the socks were, the soldier's best friend was always a nice, dry pair. Living in the sun.
What?
Yeah.
Forrest Gump, the Lieutenant Dan talked to them about socks the moment he got there.
Yep.
I just can't remember the quote.
Lieutenant Dan, what happened to your legs?
Lieutenant Dan, you got new legs.
Magic legs.
Hey, we got on. Yeah, we got.
Lieutenant Dan is in some kind of fruiting business. He said we don't have to worry about money no more. And that's good.
Hey, one last thing to worry about.
Where did that saw go?
I think he left it by the tree.
Did I? Okay.
Yeah, because he had to pick up the scarf.
For some reason, I need a scarf.
Say raisin.
I'm gonna leave for no raisin.
If it's a raisin, you better scarf it down.
I hate you.
Oh man, more mini games. At least the rhythm game in this, it has more frame rate than the one in fucking Alice.
That sick 5 FPS, yo.
I think I just cut his arm off. He doesn't need that, right? I like how you technically saw none of that.
Yeah.
Who needs the scarf? Why is this here? Villains letting us know what tallow is. Thank you.
I like how he was conscious throughout that entire thing.
Yeah.
Yeah, it tended to be. I mean, unless they passed out halfway through, but you know, they started out conscious.
Yeah,
whether they ended conscious or not.
Yeah, that's what I'm. That's my question. How is he so conscious? My bad.
I mean, some people, you know, they
Well, yeah, Valiant, I knew that.
It's letter just... from a Prussian soldier. My dear daughter, we are making headway through the French countryside. The landscape is beautiful. I'd much rather be enjoying it with you than killing people. I think of you all the time. Your father, Wolfgang. Amadeus, Amadeus.
I mean, there technically was anesthesia. It was called taking a big mallet and whacking someone over the head, just knocking them out. There you go.
Bourbon. Was chloroform around at the time?
That's what she used. Like that.
Okay.
I need to sneeze. I sneezed.
Okay.
Bravo, good for you.
I did it.
Hey, you did it.
Oh, I forgot. I shared on Facebook this really awesome save by, who's the Canucks goalie?
No cares, it's the Canucks.
I know, but hang on. He made Miller. He made an absolutely awesome, just, so they had pulled the goalie, but apparently, like, they saw that the Red Wings were coming back. And so the guy who went onto the ice went back, and the goalie went back on the ice and made a diving save to grab the puck out of the air before it went in the net. Like, skated back towards the net and dove to grab it just as the person shot it.
All the days, all the days. Yeah, Miller's good.
Yeah.
He's been the U.S. okay. goalie for the Olympics a few times.
Yeah, I think the past two, or is it three?
Do you need this fucking scarf? Oh, there's more. Anesthetic. I feel like this is telltale, but they're just like out of ideas, and they're like, let's throw them in here. That sounds like something Telltale would do. Okay, I still have the scarf. Okay. So, someone want to take it?
So confused by that scarf.
John, do you have an endless supply of Zippo lighters in this game?
Is that what you're playing with? Are you the one playing with the Zippo lighter?
Yeah, I was wondering that. I was wondering who was playing with that the other day. Gotcha.
I have a few of them.
Oh man, I have a needle out this time.
Jeez, that guy's like under.
I had to use the Y button. That's how you know it's getting serious.
That guy's a German.
Jackal? It's a jackal.
Who decided to put the spike on the German helmet?
It's for defensive purposes.
Really?
Against saber attack.
The French officers were talking about Belgium.
I suppose.
The German army was about to experiment with a new weapon.
I figured it was more of just an intimidation thing.
His hometown. Anna got en route to warn her father about the imminent danger. Reaching the outskirts of the city, Anna was greeted by the screams of sirens.
The sound of sirens.
Oh, you never found out who needed that scarf.
Fuck that scarf. Villain, make me poutine, please. And by that I mean we'll go to Smokes in like 2 weeks.
Yes.
I may or may not be a little bit jealous.
You're a lot jealous, and I am writhing in it.
No, only a little. I can live without poutine. What I can't live without is Geta, and I didn't bring any home from Kentucky this past time.
Well, you're flying. That would have been really hard.
Not really. I actually had some room in my suitcase because I threw a couple of shirts out while I was in there.
How funny it would be if I could just skip this whole section. It's like, oh, fuck it.
It's just your hometown. No big deal.
Fuck.
Peanut rag and put over your face.
So everybody's like running and coughing and you're just fine.
This is fine.
Your friend Captain Kate has been one.
Everyone's showing up.
This is why you shouldn't work like a normal human.
Yeah.
Exactly.
I kinda... Yeah, as much as I like streaming and having an audience, I kind of enjoy my mic.
The sounds. Oh, there's a few cogs I need. Oh, there's another one. Oh, is this the kind of... this kind of puzzle? Okay. Get four gears, you have to put them in the right place.
That was in an Uncharted game.
Hi, Kate. Ring the bell 3 times. Okay. I didn't mean to get that achievement, but okay. I was just being annoying. Hey, I got the puzzle right the first time.
Hey.
I at least think that was a puzzle. I don't know if you could have fucked it up.
I think it was Uncharted 3. I'm going with 3. There was a gear puzzle.
I don't remember that from 1 or 2, so maybe...
Yeah, I'm pretty sure it's 3.
Okay.
Because it's like in an underground area. Like a tomb of some sort, I think.
Allez, cuisine.
Allez, cuisine.
Shokugeki.
God, that's a show I haven't watched in a while.
I've watched the show Food Wars once. It was with Villain and Troy, and I had no idea what the fuck was happening.
People ate food and then simultaneously orgasmed.
Yes.
Is that what that show's about?
Yes.
Kind of. At least it starts out that way, and then it tries to get somewhat serious.
I mean, all of the recipes it has are, like, real recipes.
Oh, I don't doubt it.
And, like, all the food things they do are real, but... Yeah, it has people orgasming after eating food.
It's quite
broken
humorous.
Walking stick. The knob is all that remains of this walking stick. The stick has been carefully sculpted a souvenir of the trenches. Unfortunately, a broken walking stick is of no use to anyone.
I mean, you're not wrong.
The sounds of silence. Kate, you Snapchatted earlier a picture of Cass that made him look like a ball of orange fury. Like, the entire snap was just orange cat.
I mean, that is the epitome of Cass.
Normally, like, Cass is in frame and you can see the stuff around him, and this picture is just literally all Cass.
Remind me to do that with Rachel's cats.
I couldn't do that with my dog because then it'd be like, why did you just send me a black picture?
Actually, as far as Rachel's cats go, I feel like the last time I was down there, I did Snapchat a shitload of pictures of them.
I do remember a lot of pictures of the cats.
I mean, they're freaking adorable. And
letter from a Scottish soldier.
There were numerous days where I was effectively just at Rachel's house by myself with her cats, so it was like, hey!
Hello,
kitties.
Pal. I'm in the town of Ypres in Belgium, a pretty wee town that must have been bra before the war. The beer too ain't bad. I'd much rather be downing ale with you, though, boy. I'm off to the front in 2 days. Take care of yours in. Take care of yours in. And say how do to the family. Yep, that was totally Scottish.
Take care of yourself. Also, I think it's Ypres. Or, I don't know, how do you pronounce that?
The sound.
Hello, silence.
My old friend. Man, more button minigames. Sweet.
You'd never stop talking to the darkness, don't you, John?
The band The Darkness? No, I've never met them.
Oh wait, no, I'm way off.
God damn it.
How are you supposed to pronounce this? It's French, apparently.
That's... I have a minigame to fucking give her water, really?
surprised there's not a mini game for wiping your own ass.
That's in the DLC.
The DLC.
Evidently.
Wooden top. Wooden top would string a common toy of the age. During the war, toys gradually became more war-based. Through board games, children could fight out famous battles while other items ridiculed the enemy. After the war, toys and games became more pacifist once more.
That was close. It's Ypres.
It's World War One. One of your characters has a doge, one of your characters is a swole American, and one of you is a tiny woman with a stick.
It's not that tiny.
The American's trying to get revenge on a German guy. The French guy is, his daughter married a German. The French guy got captured. The German guy and the French guy met at the POW camp, and now we're helping people because we are the best medic. I have the best medics. And there's a shit ton of collectibles.
So it's Banjo-Kazooie meets World War One meets side-scroller puzzler.
Saying this is like Banjo-Kazooie would mean like...
I know. It was a joke.
No, I'm saying would mean like we would need 8 times the amount of collectibles. And they'd have to be like 100 of each instead of just 100 total. Thank you, Kate.
How about some DK64 level of collectibles?
Now you're just getting ridiculous.
That's death.
Yeah, kid, I think that's what it's going for. Just kind of shows the horrors of the time.
Okay. Must be missing someone.
Such a horrible piece of shit.
I'm still missing 3 collectibles, too. A girl has a stick that you can beat the shit out of someone. Kate, did you just try hosting me a second time just with a notification?
Didn't look like it meant to me first.
No, it did.
No, it totally did.
I saw the Pikachu.
I saw it just now.
Then you're really behind.
Speaking of which...
Thank you, bro.
I'm so glad that you guys, I think it was you, John, and Villain told me about the share or host button.
The button.
With Better Twitch TV.
He's a kitty.
What else do I have to do? I think I've saved everyone.
Save me!
Save me! Hi, villain. Don't leave a power.
Wake me up inside.
I can't wake up. Gosh, I can't wake up.
Gosh.
See, if I start singing, I could get in trouble now. She really hates that song.
Yeah, this game is, Hannah was in love with it.
Oh, is she the reason why you're playing it tonight?
No, she loved the art. She's never played this game.
Oh, okay.
Yarp.
Gulp.
I don't
know. The hook?
I don't know what to do next.
I also still like the fact that nobody has eyes.
The hills have eyes.
Just
about to say that.
Oh, so do the owls. The owls are have eyes and they're always watching.
Okay, so there's poisonous gas this way. Maybe there's something else. Hello, darkness, my old friend.
You talk to darkness a lot.
That's much as I love the Goofy thing, I have to listen to Goofy sing Christmas songs every time I'm at work.
Ugh.
That's... Oh, God.
Kate, I'm sorry.
I am so sorry. God.
Gorsh!
Gorsh!
She's going to kick you in the nuts next time she sees you.
They had to.
That is a dick punch right there.
Oh my.
Christmas is terrible. What are you talking about?
Don't say that around Clever.
Clever,
he'll start singing.
Yeah.
He'll start singing every Christmas carol ever.
It's a villain hates us all now. It's okay.
Yep.
One day she might love us again.
I mean, I just stayed where I started, so I think I'm okay. You guys have to redeem yourselves.
Hey, I found a phone.
Yay!
Bedpan! That looks like a teacup. Latrines were generally housed inside in the yard or homes of all social classes, so during the night, bedpans were used, and the well-to-do household servants were charged with emptying the pans.
Sounds like a lovely job. Shitty, but lovely.
But don't. You own a bedpan?
That's like a chamber pot. Well, that's right, she's told me this. She uses it as a puke bucket. Except she wrote puck bucket.
There once was a girl from Puck Bucket. I even hate myself for that joke. Jeez.
That's enough. Stereoscopic camera. A camera that captures two simultaneous images on glass plates, enabling relief images. Use of this camera is relatively widespread because the device was small and readily transportable.
The first ever VR headset.
How do I save this person? Or are they just dead? Both are perfectly fine out. Might have forgotten. Kate, for me to pull you in, you need to be in a channel. You have to go into like AFK and I can drag you in.
Or Pokemon Center. Doesn't matter.
Okay. I did it.
Yay.
You did it.
Come on, Domino's. Everybody, let's go.
I was wondering when someone was gonna make one.
Did I get all the collectibles? I did, sweet. Chemical formula, 2Cl2, 2H2O, equals 4HCl plus O2.
You have got to be shitting me.
Hey, Kate, by the way.
This formula is the description of what happens to soldiers' lungs when they inhale chlorine gas. Chlorine gas reacts with water in the lungs to produce hydrochloric acid, creating horrendous burns.
But it also produces oxygen, like, so maybe it's a good thing.
I don't think that... I don't know. I'm pretty sure that's not how that works in the slightest.
Yeah.
I'm fairly certain I don't want to breathe hydrochloric acid.
But that's what all the cool kids are doing.
I can barely hear
you're
you, Kate.
You're very muffled.
Yeah.
Discord says that, like,
oh,
my
there
mic
go.
Is... Oh, I didn't do anything different.
It sounded like you
was
moved.
Your microphone was, like, under something.
It's in my laptop.
Was your laptop, like, against,
no.
your bed or something?
Nope, I didn't move it.
Well.
No, villain's not in the voice chat. Now.
But.
Sorry.
But remember how I said my mind is weird? When you picked up the chamber pot, I suddenly had, I don't know what else to call it, a flashback, an epiphany that... In Wallace and Gromit and the wrong trousers, in the spare room, there's a chamber pot under the bed. I never understood what it was, because I thought it was just a giant teacup. And I'm like, why is that under that bed? And it just hit me now that was a chamber pot.
There was something that didn't have a handle.
I had to Google the picture, but I found it, and sure enough.
They've gone wrong. Stop them, Gromit. Stop them.
I've never seen that movie.
Have you seen any of the Wallace and Gromit movies?
No.
Oh. Some really good claymation. Except the first one isn't that high quality. You can really tell.
Another mini game.
Ooh.
This time we have to push two buttons at once.
Ooh, getting fancy.
Now we're giving her chloroform.
Yay, cancer.
Pretty sure that's what the SG you guys say.
Oh my god.
Okay. Oh my god, you killed her. Wait, did you? I don't know, I'm fine.
She's actually dead, yeah.
Also, you're the pushing on her stomach, her, not her lungs. Her father,
yeah, you're not scientist. A good medic.
Who was eager to use scientific advances, like, in warfare.
Anna set out in pursuit of the Baron and encountered Emilia and Freddy.
Sorry. Oh, hey, we're back to
destiny
current time, I think.
Brought them together.
You're not gonna be saving
they
people like
survived
that.
The enemy's wrath, their gunfire. Bombardments, gas attacks.
Emil and Freddy.
Now, with her father within reach, Anna wasn't going to let him sleep.
Oh yeah, we set a Zeppelin on fire too.
Oh.
With grenades.
As you do.
All Hindenburg on that sumbitch.
Maybe he did.
Here's our puppy, by the way. I'm gonna pet. Oh, I'm gonna pet.
Pet puppy.
Maybe John did actually set fire to the Hindenburg.
I mean, not necessarily set fire to the Hindenburg itself, but just go all Hindenburg up on that bitch.
Oui, bon chien. C'est bien. Oui, bon chien.
Because that just totally makes so much sense.
I like how I'm not. Yeah. I'm like a couple inches away from him.
Just not even touching it.
Life and death of the Zeppelin. The Zeppelin was a I read 30 historical facts and got an achievement. The Zeppelin was effective at the start of the war, and in 1915, London suffered over 50 Zeppelin raids before the Royal Naval Air Service intervened. The craft's weak spot was obviously its hydrogen-filled balloon. Hydrogen is lighter than air, hence its value to aviation. However, it is also highly inflammable, and the slightest spark sent the craft plummeting spectacularly groundward in a ball of flames. Of the 92 craft used during the war, 68 were destroyed. Facial disfiguration. By 1918, there were 20 million war wounded, all countries included. Roughly 70% of the injuries came from shrapnel, and only 1% from bayonets. Facial injuries could result in having a jaw, nose, or eyes removed, but progress in surgery saved and patched up, in quotes, many victims of facial disfigurement and amputation, of which there were 200,000 post-war.
Oh, shit. C'est bien. Oui, bon chien. Bon chien.
I'm petting a dog.
C'est bien.
So why is the word inflammable the same as the word flammable?
Oui, bon chien.
English.
I mean, we've proven many times during the stream that English isn't this game's strong suit.
I got caught.
Hey!
So are they keeping you? Do they not want you to go because you're a woman or just because soldiers?
Because you're Soldier 76. You're dead.
We're all soldiers now.
Virgin Mary statuette and case. A case containing a statuette of the Virgin Mary, another example of trench art. To overcome their boredom, soldiers would set up to work transforming anything that came to hand. Unexploded ammunition, empty cartridges, and shell debris were all turned into day-to-day items and put into a more pacifist use.
This is like a hardcore edutainment game.
It is, really. Like, you could technically go the whole game without reading any of these, but it's cool facts.
They are, like, genuinely interesting and so cool.
Oh, I missed.
That is one irregular heartbeat.
Then
yeah, it's
flatline.
Not really like consistently one way or the other either. It's just fucked up.
I mean, it wouldn't be a silly rhythm game.
I like how even in this art style they gave the female character cleavage.
That's.
I mean
how would you know she was a girl if she didn't have big tits?
I mean, people are that stupid.
Yeah.
C'est bien.
Also, set in 1917.
It's 1915.
Same fucking difference. Developed in 2015.
I don't know if she's. Are we green or red?
You're blue.
She's saving Germans.
Well, because, we can check her diary.
Because the soldiers won't save them because, you know, they're the enemy. So she's going and saving everybody. You know. She doesn't care about which side they're on. They're a person in need, so she's going to save them.
The bells were over Paris, started chiming at 4 p.m. this afternoon. It was eerie. Somebody in the street told me it was for the troop mobilization in case Germany declared war. In case Germany declared war, so she is French.
But, John, you're actually blue, because if you were green, you would die.
Dabu-dee-dabu-dee.
I know, that's the actual
took
song.
Me a second.
I hate you so much.
Took me a second there.
I'm not gonna read all those, I was just doing that in case there's an achievement for reading all those. Hey. I have a pup, that's all I care about.
Embrace the pupper.
I like how he's used as a distraction by getting soldiers to pet him.
Letter from a soldier. Dear Emma, we are on the retreat. Our position is untenable. Don't worry, I'm still in good health. We are going to leave Rhymes to the enemy. Rhymes is a beautiful city. Oh, all is well at home. And you are taking good care of our parents. I hope the prisoners are working properly for you. See you soon, Siegfried.
Wrong boy.
Boo!
That's every one of my jokes. Get used to them.
Thank you, Papa. Well, you're just gonna have to wait a second. Because I'm checking for
person in need.
Hey, I found him.
Did you just warp?
I went from one plane of existence to another.
Yeah, like, you crossed a very large distance.
I also just got 50 historical items. The next one's for every single one, which I think so far I've only missed, like, three. That's 200 gamer score. All the other achievements are all secrets.
Secret to everybody.
Villain, there's also two of them. There's one on my computer and then one from the Xbox. A broken P08 pistol designed for German artillerymen. The P means parabellum, which refers to the 9mm ammunition. The word parabellum comes from the Latin civis passium parabellum. If you want peace, get ready for war. Isn't that a Megadeth song?
Yes. If you want peace, prepare for war.
Yeah.
That's a Children of Bodom song.
Oh, okay.
Oui, bon chien.
I wanted to help the guy and I pet the dog by accident.
Priorities.
Actually a good song. Not a song you would like.
No. But a screaming vocal that I like.
Very much so. What? Looks like this one that's on there.
Puffer.
Hey!
How does your screen randomly turn black and white? Oh wait, never mind, that's you trying to call the pupper, isn't it?
Yeah, it's the bumpers.
Okay. I was like, why is it just randomly turning black and white? And then I remembered usually there's buttons, and that's when you're trying to call the dog.
And I have a can. I don't know why.
Just because you can.
You can do it.
You can dance if you want to.
Behind.
Do I throw it at this? That's exactly what I do, because it makes an explosion.
Ooh!
It was a live round, so I hit it and it went boom.
And then goes the dynamite.
Quite the explanation there.
Oh wait, that was it up for a little bit.
He's got no legs.
Oh, I see what I have to do.
Wait, nope, nope, there they are. I just couldn't see them.
Yeah, there's nothing really brutal shown in this game.
Yeah. I thought he was missing legs, but he's just got really tiny boots for really big pants.
It's really weird.
So this game actually could be used for edutainment, because there doesn't seem to be much gore.
Wait, do you remember that song?
What one?
Raw Dog.
Yeah. Fucking terrible.
I love the fact the song about raw dogging is in a fucking Guitar Hero song. A game.
You know why that song was in the game.
Because there was a wasn't it by one of the harmonix devs?
No, it was a harmonix held a contest for, like, bands to submit shit. It was an original song written by some band that won a contest. To basically have their song.
This is our French friend. The swole motherfucker right there is the American.
Today I learned Children of Bodom covered I'm Shipping Up to Boston.
I love that song.
Have you ever heard that song in friggin' harsh metal?
No, I have not.
Nor do I ever want it.
I have not heard either of them.
You've probably heard it, like, in a movie or something.
Maybe, but...
The Oh, God, I lit myself on fire.
Good job.
What were you gonna say about the American, though? Before that?
He was on the other side.
Thank you.
I like how you die immediately from the fire.
Yeah.
That is some effective fire right there.
Oh, yeah, I've heard this. Okay.
I was gonna say, as soon as you hear that, like,
where?
That first little melody.
What movie have I heard, seen this in? Or heard this in?
Oh.
I think it was in, Catch Me If You Can or something like that?
It's been in a bunch of movies.
That's a movie I haven't heard of in a while. Jesus.
Here's the version.
I feel like this was in Pirates of the Caribbean too.
No, no.
Are you sure?
I have 100%.
This song.
Okay.
The place I know I know this song from is the Samuel Adams commercials for their Boston Lager.
Boston Lager.
Oh yeah, that's where I heard it from.
Yep.
Okay.
You know, not the Pirates of the Caribbean movies, the beer commercial.
Yes!
I mean, have you seen how many times beer commercials play? Like, Christ. I think the whole country was alcoholics.
Kind of is.
Well, yeah.
I did nothing. Got it.
Hey, Walt! Well, get away.
Did that dog have a stick of dynamite in its mouth?
It totally did.
That might not be the smartest thing to do.
See you, Yu-Yu.
Bye, Yu-Yu.
Bye, Yu-Yu.
Dynamite. That's more. I don't see a place to put
this. I also like how the soldier doesn't care that the dog just grabbed a stick of dynamite. He's just like, I'll let it do whatever it wants.
Oh, shit. Children of Bodom covered Jesse's Girl?
That's
what?
Awful.
What the?
Whoa, no, now.
I love the Gregorian chant version of... I don't even know, there's too many to list, but, like, there's a band that just does Gregorian chants of, like, popular songs. And, like, so they've done, like, some Evanescence stuff. My favorite one is The Last Unicorn, but, like, they've done some really weird out there shit.
Hey, look!
Zebia, Zebia.
Okay,
this cover
no,
is actually pretty good.
Sorry, I'm not into the heavy metal.
What, Jesse's girl or the... Oh, Lord. Oh, no.
It also proves that most metal bands' lead singers actually can sing other than scream.
Merci, mon ami. Oui. Allez, oui.
I still don't understand how people who have played this game did not accidentally pet the dog.
Okay, actually, yeah, it is pretty good. There's just that one part where it started getting to the really screamy, where I was like, okay, no.
Well, that's Children of Bodom basically injecting their style, right?
Yeah. But the rest of the song is, yeah, it's a decent cover.
Now for something completely different.
And now for with a tape recorder up his nose.
Oh, I thought you actually linked that. Damn.
Oh, do you want me to?
I mean, I wouldn't mind.
Since we're linking interesting covers of shit.
Victory had a bittersweet taste for Anna. Carl, seriously wounded, had been sent to a POW camp. Anna's father
this
had disappeared.
This is really similar
Baron
to the original so far.
There,
and
done.
And Emil was court-martialed for desertion. Cited for his bravery in Reims, Emil was fortunately pardoned and set free. Free.
Tip of the dudes in the background going, biddly, 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 biddly.
Yeah.
Well, the idea is everything but the drums in that is a cappella.
Okay. It sounds a little goofy.
We're now in 1916, by the way.
I say a cappella with some big air quotes because they do a lot of digital sound processing to it.
Emil and
the American, the French, and the Doge are in Verdun.
That
villain has ravioli.
The arrival of the mail.
Yay!
Okay, their cover of Battery is a little bit funnier.
You missed, villain. Anna got caught.
Food was scarce. The disease was
German,
rife, and the number of dead was growing.
Like, son-in-law went to a POW news, however, camp, and then the father got pardoned for
his grandson, Victor.
Got pardoned for
standing on both feet and
fleeing, and got sent back to the front line. And the American was just there.
Don't worry, sir.
Now I'm just listening through like all of the female fronted metal bands that I've ever listened to.
That's what I'm doing too.
I'm still watching the Monty Python clip.
Yeah, I'm still watching it
in stereo.
Stereo.
Okay, I'll stop you before you get to Arch Enemy. You probably won't like them.
I don't know, I'm on Nightwish right now.
Nightwish is
good.
Arch Enemy is like, if you didn't know that their lead singer was female, you probably wouldn't have known that. Unless
ooh, interesting.
Tobacco case. Tobacco case because made from shell casings. Empty munitions were often recycled. Some exploded shell materials were already anesthetically interesting. Aesthetically interesting.
That's a bit of a mistake.
Otherwise, soldiers would rework their finds to create handy items. Tobacco was precious, so so men were eager to keep it dry. Many accounts from the trenches express their appreciation of the Christmas cigar, a special festive treat for the troops. I like how those guys were going to tell me he needs socks or by taking his boots off.
Does he have bare feet or what?
Fucking trench foot, man. Brad and I were just like doing some hardcore research on that shit, and like how it's actually still really prevalent today among homeless people. That shit's scary.
Yeah, if you got wet feet for too long, just skin starts breaking down and whatnot.
Also, I just threw into Discord one of my favorite covers of any game ever.
Dumb shoulders love tobacco.
I mean, technically, I was supposed to end the stream half an hour.
Oh. Well.
I want to beat this chapter, though. This chapter ends. Like, we still have a little while left. Like, I think we're only halfway through. There's four chapters in this game, but they're the longest fucking chapters ever.
Merci, what? Dude, Mike, how does this girl make her voice do this?
I've wondered that same thing for a while.
Which
one? I like Arch Enemy, but I don't understand how she makes herself sound like that.
Card game. Days in the trenches
usually
were long.
Usually female fronted. Sorry.
That's what. Days in the trenches were long, and to overcome their boredom, they would play cards, read, write, and create objects from materials they found. The Germans played scat, the French menel, and the Allies brag or pontoon, amongst others.
Jesus, how's she doing that? Like, holy shit.
I found nasty socks. They like...
I mean, have any of you listened to Abnormality?
Mm-hmm. Fucking Visions.
That's what... probably one of the most offensive sounding.
You just took those that sock off of barbed wire. I think there'd be a small problem with that.
Fair warning, this song is a garbled mess, but it's another example of, arguably, they allege that it is a song,
It just sounds like he has a cock in his throat. That's all I hear from him.
That's a woman.
That's a female.
Wait, in Abnormality?
Yeah. Yes.
That song Visions by Abnormality, that's a female-fronted grunge metal band.
Oh, great. Now it just sounds sexist. Fuck. All right.
Really the worst.
Wait, are you surprised at this point, John, or...?
No.
Yeah, well.
There you go. I need to find a quill.
Pas de brignol pour toi, bigorno.
Oui. Excuse me. Oh, hey, there's facts I can read. Feeding, 18 months later, barbed wire, Verdun. Is that a man kissing a man? Invented in 1874, barbed wire was already a common feature of trench protection in battle. But with the Great War on us, on trench warfare, it became widespread. Thousands of tons were deposited in no man's land. Both sides sought tools and strategies to overcome barbed wire, such as grappling irons and wire cutters. Intensive bombardment was deemed to be the most effective method, and the tactic became widespread. dead soldiers putrefy.
Sorry.
You did it.
Putrefying on barbed wire remains one of the enduring images of the war. I don't know why the plate is just there. The bread line.
Northwood, but Breton.
Mike, have you heard that Scarborough Affair cover that I want?
Yeah, I listened to it. It's good.
Well, they're handing out bread.
Yeah, I'm trying to... I need to get a quill.
Merci,
and I need to get... I think I need to get bread so I can get that bird's attention for some reason.
I mean, it's a messenger, pigeon, I'd assume? I want to be a dove.
I don't know where to find a quill. Oh, yeah.
This is the only cover I can think of.
Between the Bear and Me has a Bohemian Rhapsody cover, which is amazing.
You have accidentally pet that dog so many times.
Because I keep hitting A to make sure I don't get any, I don't miss secrets.
Yeah, I know.
Fine. Okay, the pan and the bird. Yes, but it doesn't let me touch the pan. I just look at it like I'm confused about why there's a pan on the table.
Swiggity swiggity, coming for that dog booty.
I think you're right, you need to put a bread into that pan. Then the bird will come down.
Yeah.
But I don't know how to get bread.
Can you stand in line?
Just stand there.
Oh, I was gonna say you go to work. You know, bread, money.
Fun fact, messenger pigeons just don't just fly anywhere, they fly back to their mate. Zebra has to be mate. Was that it? The dog just had to get it for me.
Oh. It would be cool if you actually did have to wait in line, though.
Yeah.
Would it?
Less. Sorry.
Is the dog scaring it away or what?
He was, yeah, I had to walk away. Okay, I was just supposed to get the quill from him. He's not like...
Oh, he doesn't have a message.
I heard from Carl. His condition is stable.
Weird, I promise.
It's not weird, I promise.
It's
I hope to find an
oh my gosh.
To visit him.
That's not gonna end well.
Thank you for the photo.
Did Snapchat really do that?
Yeah, you can do a lot of, like, filtering things now without the face recognition.
Ooh, that is cool.
Yeah.
No, I did the same thing twice. Okay, there's just constant barrage that way. The third time was me trying to see if there was a secret over there, but it's just such a constant barrage, you can't get over it. That guy died.
Oh, and now they put the face filters on the other cam too, in case you wanted to take a picture of someone rather than taking a selfie.
It's really cool, actually.
The only way I can say this word is brazier. A helmet with holes in it, filled with coal and wood, and used as a brazier. I guess that makes sense. The item would have afforded some protection from the cold, although helmets were made of metal, they only offered scant protection from bullets.
That particular spelling of the word is brazier. Because brazier refers to, you know...
The bra.
Plus, I think brazier is spelled B-R-A-Z-E-E-R.
No.
No.
Sure. Are you sure? I swear I'm not completely stupid.
Okay.
Just died.
I've got it here. B-R-A-S-S-I-E-R-E.
There you go.
Yeah. Okay, well, at least I knew it was spelled different.
Oh.
I like your brazier.
A little bit. Right. Why all is right. There so much dynamite right here? What the fuck?
Good question.
There is really a surprising...
so much explosions.
There's a surprising lack of gore for it being a World War One game.
That's a shitload of dynamite. Oh yeah, my god.
Shocking.
The Snapcat!
That is a little oven mitts.
The signature Snapcat. You need to remember to send as many as possible.
You should see Cass's bald little tongue. You know he has 4 whole nipples?
Okay, that was like the most, that was the best way to deliver that statement that you would have ever
4
envisioned.
Whole nipples, but does he have any half nipples or?
Yeah.
How about a quarter?
A quarter, 3 quarters of a nipple.
Not that I've discovered, but there is part of his stomach that is yet unshaved, so he could have more nipples yet. But in the shaved part of his belly, there are 4. And it's adorable.
That's kind of how cats work.
Officer's whistle.
At least the female variant of said feline would utilize those for...
Officers were issued with whistles to signal the men when to charge. The sound of the whistle became synonymous with a journey into the unknown where soldiers surged out of the trenches and into no man's land.
We're all soldiers now. That's the female cat I had growing up, so I don't know.
Not dead yet.
Maybe he really is.
Your cat is triggered, I'm sorry to say.
Did you just assume your cat was
just because he has no balls and no penis doesn't mean that I can assume his gender.
I think I broke Serbia.
I mean, at this point, he doesn't really have a gender.
Die.
That's it. Get the hook. We're done.
I'm sorry. Oh, God.
You're gonna be okay there, buddy.
Oh, no. Not gonna be okay.
It's okay. It is okay. Okay, because you're laughing so hard you can cause yourself to have a heart attack.
But My Chemical Romance told me that I'm not okay. I promise that.
Letter from a Tunisian soldier. Dear father, dear family, I'm cold. The land we are defending is frozen and covered in snow. The ground is so iced up it is harder than rock. We cannot dig. The cold is so intense that my hands are burning. I hope everything's fine back in the village and you're still receiving half my pay. Tell me if you aren't. Ahmed.
Assuming that was on the Eastern Front.
Well, it's all quiet on the Western Front.
The Western.
But it's all cold on the Eastern.
Western.
The Western.
Patrick, you're fired again.
It goes crabs.
Would you like a job starting right now?
Boy, would I!
You're fired.
God damn it, kid.
Did I miss?
What, Kate, what did you do?
Oh, I just tweeted out what Mike said.
Oh.
Oh, God.
Oh, man. Cass, you can be whatever gender you want to be. Gender is a social construct.
Okay, yes, but what I meant to... Well, I guess what I should have said is, your cat doesn't really have a sex anymore. Because he's lost the two components that generally determine it.
Well, he's still got, like, one X and one Y chromosome.
Yeah, I was gonna say that.
Yeah, when you get down to the molecular and cellular.
I suppose level, that's true.
He's... Essentially, he's just a unit.
He's a unit, yeah!
He simply
much.
Is.
Make sure he doesn't start any cults.
He started a cult long ago, and I am, like, drinking that Kool-Aid.
The cult is casting.
Ooh, that's not fancy.
John, you chose, like, the exact wrong time to get out of that trench.
Yep.
Doesn't work too well for him.
I don't know. I feel like you would have gotten to bed like 2 hours ago.
Well, it's just Friday, so.
Today is my Friday.
Yeah. Does that mean you work Sundays?
Yes.
Ouch.
Not as bad as it sounds.
I guess. Fair enough.
Colored pennant.
Actually, as far
guys,
as...
Guys, John's having a stroke!
Also, the way you can tell this was made by a French-Canadian, there's a U in colored.
Yep.
Although Morse code was already operational, due to technical problems, telephone communications were unreliable, so age-old techniques were used, such as drums, bugles, and colored pennants. November 11th...
Imagine someone throwing, like, snacks.
November 11th, 1918, which is today.
Yeah, that's
today!
Yeah,
holy shit, that's today!
That's today! Nice timing, dude!
Well, that's today, 2 years.
Whoa, what the fuck?
At 11 a.m., the end of the war was marked by a clarion call.
Basically, everyone has a U in color other than the Americans.
So, essentially, I started playing this game 98 years after the end of the war.
Yeah.
I did it. I did the timing.
You did it. Proud of you.
Dude, this guy's bag nipples.
How many nipples does it have?
If it's less than 4, then it's not as cool as Cass.
Yep.
And they have to be whole nipples.
No 2% reduced fat nipples.
No, it's almond nipples.
Skim nipples.
I forget in this game you can put a grenade in your dog's mouth and be like, yeah, it's cool.
I guess in this case there's more than one way to skim a cat.
Jesus Christ. And here I was about to make a soy nipples joke.
I want almond nipples.
This conversation.
But are the nipples homogenized?
Ooh, I don't know.
They're pasteurized.
John, what did you think would happen when you picked up that grenade?
I knew I needed it anyway, so I just killed myself to go back to the beginning.
Okay, just making sure.
like, ooh, I found a little explodey pineapple.
Woo! Whoa!
Exploding pineapple nipples.
Pineapple nipples. Pine nipples.
Do you know pineapple in almost every single other language is ananas?
Yep.
Ananas?
Like A-N-A-N-A-S.
It's like banana, so with no B.
Ananas.
Okay. In like every other language.
Yeah. Almost every other language.
That's weird.
Also, in French, French word for grapefruit is pamplemousse.
Mm-hmm.
Yep.
That's wonderful.
The German word for poison is gift.
That makes a lot of sense now.
Yeah, it does, doesn't it?
Also, the German word for fat is dick.
Oh my.
The German word for... I was trying to make a joke, and I forgot the German Prime Minister's name.
Angela Merkel?
Yeah, I was gonna say the German word for bitch is Angela Merkel.
Sad, she's not a bitch.
John, Travis is asking why is chat the same way?
Hi, Travis.
Hi.
What's disabled?
Your chat in Twitch.
What's that?
It says chat is disabled for this channel.
There are people typing currently.
Yeah, Villain and Mike are doing it. Oh, that sounds weird. Sorry.
Unbanned.
Oh, there it goes.
Kate, it's okay. Rachel's asleep.
It said versus Termus is not banned in this room, so.
Working now.
You probably just weren't connected or something.
Chat disappeared for me. I bet you the chat server is exploding.
Why are we high-fiving, Mike?
Because I made a terrible joke.
You always
make
terrible jokes.
And Rachel's not here to yell at me.
That's like 98% of your existence is terrible jokes.
Sad.
What's the other 2%? Is it milk?
It's filthy memes.
Oh. This is the dankest of memes. They're undank. I'm so sorry. Should I find a rare pet knife for you?
Yes, please.
1 second.
Feeling bad now.
Aw.
Where am I shooting? I don't remember where I'm shooting. I assume this.
You'd be a terrible soldier.
Oh, this game actually does height. Got it.
Oh, you gotta account for that.
I think that's what I'm aiming. Wait, that's probably not what I'm aiming for then. The fuck?
There you go. There's your Pepe.
Jesus Christ.
Oh no!
But why does he have to be yellow?
But why male models?
Fucking Zoolander. What am I aiming for? He keeps saying windmill. And that's exactly what I'm hitting every time.
Aim for the giants.
Well, and also trees. So, like, you have to get trees out of the way?
I think so. I'm gonna aim for this, like, church.
Windmill was, like, left and right. Trees was, like, up and down.
Yeah.
That's where I'm trying to figure out.
You thought, therefore, you was. Windmill. You can't really figure it out.
Went to the right of the windmill. above the trees, maybe?
Oh, yeah. Yeah. So go right of the windmill, and then, like, up from those trees.
Waiting for him to call one more time. Okay.
Just think about how much ammo you've wasted. Looking to the, like, keep moving further right of the windmill until you see trees.
As far right as I can go.
Huh.
It's not like reverse because you're in a fucking telescope thingy, is it? I know it's not called a telescope.
Maybe it is left of the.
Like,
left
is down, like, maybe it's reversed.
I don't know. I wouldn't think so.
I haven't even seen, like, what trees that could be referring to.
Me neither. Oh wait, it is reversed, I think.
No, I can't go left that much at all.
Okay. Wait, well, there's some trees, like, right? I see the trees. They're closer up in the front.
Oh yeah, there they are. Okay, so, yeah.
Right near the bottom, with, like, a house to the right of them.
Got it.
Yay! Teamwork!
That was harder than it should have been.
My precision cannon firing.
You just cost that country like $10,000 right there.
Maybe it's
military
hierarchy.
Yeah.
Heard of their feats in battle.
I don't know. It's World War One. You gotta account for the bravery.
Wait, did that just say
Emil received good?
Did that just say Emil's precision aiming?
Carl was we just made fun of that. Yes.
Yeah, the guy's name is Emil.
Oh, I didn't hear you. Sorry.
Meanwhile, the battle for Verdun only grew longer and bloodier. The death toll was staggering: 70,000 per month, almost one Frenchman and one German every minute, and it went on for 10 months, day and night.
We are, like, 3/4 of the way done with this chapter.
May 8th, 1916.
Well, it did get slowed down by your precision cannon.
A strategic point in the German defense.
Mike is just posting all of the emotes. And I want Starburst.
That's right, I've got candy here.
May 8th, 1916. You're ruining my chat experience, Mike.
Do you want me to time him out? Just kidding.
Flamethrowers! The Germans were the first to use flamethrowers in an assault on a previously held position in July 1915. Although the attack was expected, the use of the weapon came as a surprise and caused a large number of casualties.
Play Freebird!
Its psychological impact was huge, but British troops soon learned to cope with the slow-moving operatives lugging heavy equipment and not adapt the weapon themselves.
I do like how all of these pictures are colorized.
Yeah. God damn it, Mike. Mike, if you're gonna do that, at least donate to me.
I have already. Maybe $5.
Wow.
Oh, okay.
What?
Remember that?
I do. Okay. I wonder if I dig down into each of these, I'll die.
Yeah, dig down in all the places where there's skulls. There's no harm, no risk.
No risk, no reward. You gotta risk it for the biscuit.
Is this gonna kill me?
Give that kitty a chin scratches for me.
I like how you didn't notice that the one that you actually were supposed to dig in did not have an arrow pointing towards it with the skull sign.
I just got like the mother load of Starburst 2-packs. I got 2
rings. Cass was licking my finger and I grabbed his tongue. I don't know why. I just wanted to, and like I actually got it. It felt really weird.
I mean, sure it's a tongue. It's pure
muscle.
I'm sure
he quite enjoyed it.
I'm sorry.
Trench shovel. French army trench shovel.
This is the shovel the Adventures of Kate and Cass. Tune in next week.
A shovel was too short to be of any real use digging trenches or tunnels. However, French soldiers sharpened the tool's blade to turn into a weapon more effective than a bayonet.
I like how the thing specifically designed to dig trenches was useless in digging trenches. Way to go, French, I guess French army, if they were the ones that gave them out.
So the NES classic.
Nice.
Oh yeah.
I think that goes on sale at 2 p.m.
Lounge sale at midnight at the Nintendo store in New York City, and they're already sold out of them.
Yeah, it's 2 p.m. on Amazon that it goes on sale.
It's not even that good, honestly.
It's how many games?
30 games.
30 games.
But it comes with free if you buy it on Amazon, right?
Hmm? It comes with all the games.
I thought it did.
No, it's yeah, 30 it comes games. They're basically preloaded onto it. It's basically just a box that looks like an NES, but it's basically like a Raspberry Pi.
It's a plug-and-play console, basically.
And it takes Wii controllers, like the ones that you plug into the back of the
but it comes with NES controllers, right?
Yeah. But they have that connector in it. They're not having NES controllers. The nice thing is, those NES controllers, you can plug into a Wiimote, connect to a Wii U, and use that for a virtual console that way. But
that is a smart idea.
It's like Nintendo has like one good idea a year.
Basically.
A lot of good ideas.
See,
Nintendo's
how come this
biggest shortcoming is poor marketing 90% of the time.
What?
How is they're doing better now? That was probably Travis. What happened?
What did Travis do?
Donated me.
Uh-oh.
Best donation message ever.
Hold on. We'll replay the video. Oh, okay. I can't skip the... Hold on. Oh.
Now it says he's
donated like 5 minutes.
Yeah, looks like he's donated.
He donated this video. I now need to skip that like 5 times. God damn it, Travis.
Oh. This one. I love that video so much.
What the fuck? Oh, I have this. I have completely screwed myself.
How many times did you hit that button?
I don't know.
Oh boy.
Good job.
Shit was so. In case you didn't read that whole thing before it went away. says, what the fuck did you just fucking say about me, you little bitch? I'll have you know my name is John and I woke up this morning at 5:30. Woke up this morning 5:30 sharp to the smell of wet pussy. I was getting a blowjob from two bitches. Shit was so cash.
Oh my god.
What? What the fuck?
Wow.
Travis, what is wrong with you?
Everything. All the best things.
Did you know that 2012 was the only year that had two main series Mario games released? I'm looking at the Mario Maker poster right now that has like every main series Mario game, and 2012 had New Super Mario Bros. 2 and New Super Mario Bros. U.
Yeah, I forgot those came out in the same year.
Yeah.
I also enjoy how it's like New Super Mario Bros. 2 when there's been two other fucking games in the series after the first one.
No, there's actually, it goes New Super Mario Bros. And then New Super Mario Bros. Wii, and then New Super Mario Bros. 2, and then New Super Mario Bros. U. So technically it should be 3, you're right, but...
Remember when that used to be called New Super Mario Bros. Me?
Also, God. Congrats, Travis, on my accidental giving you a full event list.
The biggest drought was between 96 and 02. Jeez. 8 years without a Mario game. According to that poster. I did that math right, right? Yeah.
Empty wooden chest. An empty wooden chest used as luggage by a German soldier. Suitcases were not widespread, and poor soldiers left for war with their affairs in a knapsack. I think I need to get this fire started.
But we didn't start the fire.
Beautiful.
Best cover I've ever heard.
I'll be back. I gotta use the bathroom.
Check.
Jesus Christ. People were lining up at the Nintendo store at 5 p.m. They handed out wristbands at 7 p.m.
Contact lenses just arrived.
This was Travis, just under your name, wasn't it?
You can't have my brand.
I have special eyes.
Look.
My brand!
Look with your special eyes.
My brand!
Oh, God. Damn it.
$1 from, quote, Ravage Talon. One was trying to fit my humongous 3-pound balls in her mouth, while the other was choking halfway my 18 3/8-inch dick. She started to squirt hard. She was convulsing and having 6 orgasms at the same time.
What is that from?
I don't know, but I feel like he injected a whole marijuana at the same time during all this.
You guys underestimate the amount that Travis reads r/circlejerk.
500 marijuanas on the face.
Well, get away, boy.
She's gonna give me a dollar under all your names, isn't he?
Oh, good boy.
Have fun paying taxes on all
that. Oh man, that $1.
Oh,
Enjoy your donation spam from Travis. I'm actually gonna head out.
Okay.
Don't touch that!
Little pet.
I think I just had a mini Kit Kat that had no wafer inside.
Sad.
I was waiting for the crunch, and I only felt chocolate.
Is it?
But it's hard.
It's just one of those days. Isn't it?
It's hard to tell, though.
I hate you. I knew you were gonna fucking do it too. I fucking hate you.
It's still hard to tell, though, because I had multiple in my mouth at the same time.
Oh lord!
So
thank you now. Oh my.
So I don't know, but I think I just got ripped off in some way.
You just don't know how to justify ripping someone's head off. Let me just double check, make sure everything Travis says is going through. This happened once before.
I haven't donated anything else. I figured you probably would like me to stop.
I mean, we're entertained.
Yeah.
All about the hint that she said bullshit.
Zernix.
Oh no. What's Zernix do?
Zernix did nothing.
Oh. Oh, I get it. Okay. God damn it.
He actually linked the 10-hour version, but only donated a dollar.
Oh my god.
Zernix donated. What the desu did you fucking desu about me, you little desu? I'll have you know I graduated top of my desu in the Navy desus. I've been involved in numerous secret desus on El Desu. I have 300 confirmed desus.
Is he a master of gorilla desu?
You've now made me wonder if there's a character limit. And if you've hit it every time.
I have every time.
Yeah, Twitch Alerts does have a character limit. Or Streamlabs, sorry. I keep forgetting they changed their name.
Well, dog's about to blow up.
I was about to ask, can you blow up the dog? And or will he run into the fire if you ask him to?
I know he won't run into the fire if you ask him to, because like he knows well enough not to.
He knows that fire is bad.
Sure about that? I don't think he does.
Oh hi.
Hi.
Funny thing is, he would roughly say something like that. Weep trash.
No, that's someone completely different.
Never something. Captain Kate.
Oh, I didn't do anything!
Of Captain Jack Sparrow.
Oh my god. This one's amazing.
What in Davy Jones's locker did he just bark at me, you scurvy belligerent? I'll have
bilge
you know.
Rat.
Huh?
Bilge rat.
Bilge. Oh. I'll have you know I be the meanest cutthroat on the seven seas, and I've led numerous raids on fishing villages and raped over 300 wenches.
Why you gotta rape the wenches? That's fine. Can't you just, like, seduce the wenches?
No. Sorry.
I ye sturdy dogs.
Yarr.
It be I, Captain Kate.
Yarr.
Nice try, but not quite.
Not quite the yarr we were looking for.
I yarr. Am a captain and I can yarr however the fuck I wanna.
But it'd still be wrong.
I can't believe another Pirates of the Caribbean movie is coming out.
Is it?
Wait, really?
Yeah.
God. Why?
Because this be the tale of Captain Jack Sparrow.
Oh, God. Haven't we suffered enough?
I think it's called Dead Man.
I just watched the dog just slide ass down, like, down this little, thing. This be the tale.
Pirates so brave on the seven seas.
Thank you for the food, Troy.
I couldn't let that go untouched.
That's how I feel about a lot of butts.
Yeah, that's kind of naughty. Mm.
The dog is getting, like, fired directly above his head every other time. It's making me nervous.
I think his ears have gone in the fire several times.
Yeah, I think he's okay.
The fact that you have to climb down that ladder and just to grab another stick every time.
You can't take the box. Can't.
Oh, that is a very...
God, this is like shitty pachinko.
I don't think I can get it in there.
No, because that thing is curved in the way. Is that making it... I can't. can't tell what's the background and what's not.
There's a very small gap.
No, I don't. Is there?
No, I don't think it. I think it's not. I can't
very
do it.
Shitty pachinko. Let's see, can I throw directly in there? No, I can't. Just throw it up there and hope. Oh god, that landed.
I see it. I see it now. Do you want it? Figure it out on your own, or?
Does
it have to slide through that little gap? Oh. Okay.
Oh, I see. I didn't see the dog hole.
Oh, that. See, I saw the other side of the dog hole, but.
That sounds fun.
I know, it sounds terrible. See, I thought you had to throw a dynamite at the lever.
No, I didn't see.
But yeah, you had to have the dog go to the other side.
So he can fix the shitty pachinko. What a helpful dog.
He's a pupper.
Or is he a doggo?
Sweet doggo.
Does he have a name?
He's actually a doge.
You just gave him a piece of dynamite.
Run out of. Come. I love the fact there's no actual words in this game. Which is like kind of vague, proper sounding words.
Except for the in between stuff.
Yes, there's no direct character dialogue. Is this a tank? With a flamethrower attached to it? Yes, it is.
I hope so.
Yeah, there's no dialogue, but there is narration in between chapters.
Where did the dog go?
Where did Doggo?
Oh, there
go.
Doggo. Where did Doggo?
Really hope I don't just literally have to walk the exact same thing.
But this time with other guy.
Travers, I think you gave me like $6 tonight.
Excellent.
I don't remember the exact number. Because I hit the repeat. Hold on. 8, Xernix, Mike. You gave me $4.
But according to the event list, you gave him like $10.
I don't have a pupper.
No pupper. Because he's with the other guys.
He's currently locked in a jail cell with like a flamethrower attachment.
I missed the doggo.
Rip pupper.
German ring, an iron ring bearing the inscription Gold Gab Ich für Eisen.
Hold on, stop. I need to wait for that to pop up on the screen so I can read that correctly, because that was not right.
Wait, what?
Gold Gab Ich für
Eisen.
Eisen, thank you. That isn't
Gold Gab Ich für Eisen.
Offered in exchange for some precious item as part of a program to finance the German war effort.
Well, the weird thing is, the German word for gold isn't...
Gold?
Is gold the word for iron or something?
I don't know.
Hang on, Google Translate. Let's see how badly this messes it up. Gold Gab Ich für Eisen. Okay, it did not translate that correctly.
Wait, translate from German.
Wait, so what did it say? What was the message, like the historical? I just read the German text.
It was on the ring. It was handed out on the, like, sold for the war effort or something. It was like an iron ring.
Was the ring made of iron?
Yes.
Okay.
Apparently Eisen is iron, I think.
Yeah, Eisen is iron. So they, did they, like, trade gold for iron?
Hang on, I need to translate this word by word because Google Translate is not a good source.
Oh, it just means I gave gold for iron.
Oh. Well, that's a pretty good saying.
Maybe gold is the German word for gold.
It looks like it, yeah.
I thought...
Thank God I have this unlimited supply of dynamite.
Oh, I was thinking of the word for money, which is geld. Just kidding. I'm only a few years out of practice.
Aw, come on. My game over.
I was about to ask if you can lose here because it looks like that door is getting more and more broken.
This part's not hard, it was just I fucked up.
Ah.
You done fucked up, Aaron.
This Aaron.
Is there a Jack Wellen here?
Is Jack Wellen? Jacqueline? Where Balake? Where the hell Balake at?
Dude, this is so fucking annoying. He's like barely missing the lift.
Is it a bat lift?
And the one time I hit it, he's not back there. Hey.
Despite the fort's partial destruction, the Germans held their position. The mission was a failure.
Finish the fort mission. Chapter 3, The Poppy Fields, which I'm not starting tonight.
No!
We will finish.
My darling, war has taken away a very dear friend. He was like a brother to me, and his death affects me much more than I could imagine. In happier news, Carl is safe from the trenches, and his condition improves steadily. I'll go and see him on my next leave. And what about you? How are you? Are things in St. Miel any better?
Carl discovered things were not, in fact, any better. According to Marie's last letter, his son had fallen gravely ill. Carl had come to a decision. This war would never end. He had to escape.
Well, looks like as of when we come back to finish this game tomorrow, we'll be playing as Carl, the German, like, son-in-law.
Hmm.
Cool.
Cool. So, who did the guy lose in the explosion, though?
I don't know.
She said he lost someone who felt like a brother to him.
Was it the American, maybe?
Maybe. I mean, I don't know. Well, I hope it wasn't the dog.
Oh, no!
No! No one's really online right now. So, I'll finish this game tomorrow. We have chapters 3 and 4 left. Thank you, Kate, Servia, Villain for about 4 seconds, Mike, Hannah, Travis for, like, the money. The amount of money.
Oh, thanks. So not for my company, just for my money. I see how it is.
Basically.
Travis, I mean, are you surprised?
Travis, you need to talk less on streams. You're going to make all my audience just, like, fall in love with you. Obviously. That voice is so sexy.
Villain's like, I'm still here.
I meant when you were in call for, like, hey, the villain. 4 seconds.
Play a game.
I didn't mean in chat for 4 seconds. You've been here for hours in chat. I meant in voice call for the 4 seconds. I stole your boyfriend. I know that you're still here. And then, yeah, tomorrow we'll finish this. Good night, everyone.
Bye-bye.
Bye.